2,500 submissions in fewer than 24 hours. It's a staggering amount of opinions and input, and exactly what the four conservatives said they wanted when they launched their public consultations on sex ed last August. That's what these are. The results of Ford's promise to get more parental input on the curriculum. We wanted to know what parents had to say, so we filed a Freedom of Information request, asking for only the first 1,000 pages of submissions, a snapshot of how people are feeling. And here they are, 2,500 responses. We asked people on the street to read them out.
What complete nonsense this Ford government is. Stop funneling resources into blocking teachers in schools and support the new curriculum instead of nonsense.
I am concerned that the curriculum currently being taught will be replaced by a 20-year-old document that does not reflect the realities currently faced by students. I am also concerned that pandering to the religious right will result in changes to the curriculum currently being taught that exclude already marginalized members of our society.
I have no concern with the new curriculum. The only issue I have is that some of the time and money wasted on removing it. I was thrilled with my learning the new curriculum with his peers in a safe environment. Now I can only hope his teachers will ignore the PC government and give my son an education that is relevant.
And that's what we found, an overwhelming endorsement of the very program the government killed. So we asked the minister what they plan to do with all of this information and when we can expect to see changes.
Overwhelmingly, they support the 2015 sex ed curriculum that was cut by this government. Are you planning on listening to them and returning to that sex ed curriculum?
We're going to be listening and looking at every single submission that has come in, and I think you'll understand that when we look through the tens of thousands of submissions, digital surveys, and the results of our telephone town halls, you're going to see that we're going to be putting the right foot forward for our elementary curriculum next year.
So when do you think you're going to, what's the timeline for having that coming out?
Okay, so actually we're going to be looking at all the data through January. We're going to be writing and testing our curriculum through the spring, and we'll be introducing that elementary curriculum in for the fall of
year. Are you weighting parents differently than teachers, for example? Are you weighting parents' voices differently than teachers, for example?
Everybody's equal. Everybody's equal.
Now, in case you missed that, she said that everybody's voice will be treated equally and gave no indication of how the ministry would prioritize the opinions of education professionals or lay people in this mountain of information. Now, NDP education critic Merritt Stiles isn't surprised by the initial results of the consultation and hopes the government seriously considers the responses they've received.
The only one who doesn't want this curriculum and doesn't want kids to learn about consent and LGBTQ issues and stuff, apparently the few people that Doug Ford is listening to, some of his friends maybe, that he's made commitments to. That's what we've been saying all along. At the end of the day, this is not what Ontarians are looking for. It's not a priority for them. They want kids kept safe, they want kids to be protected, and they want kids to have modern information.
Now, we initially filed a Freedom of Information request asking for approximately 2 weeks worth of data. But after learning that it would take several months to produce those responses, we opted for a much smaller sample size. The government wouldn't tell us and couldn't tell us how many responses they received in total.